And I'm Sydney Michelli, the other co-vice president of Delta.
At this time, we would like to remind everyone to please turn off all electronic devices as they interfere with our microphone systems, and that flash photography is prohibited.
Don't forget there will be a 20-minute intermission that you can buy concessions and go to the bathroom, but don't forget that you can't come back in with beverages and food. And Peer Pals will be selling bracelets to end the R word, and all money raised is funding the Spring Invitational, which is our version of the Special Olympics. Any donation is completely, totally appreciated.
We would like to thank a ton of people for making this production possible. Mrs. Argers, the director, Mrs. Thomas, the music director, and the Mr. Argers and stage crew for building the set, and Miss Gina for the choreography. And then one final thing, as you've probably already noticed, there are fog effects in this show. So, yeah, there's just water vapor. They shouldn't cause any allergic reactions. Yeah, about it.
Live from Gordon Valley, it's Saturday night!
Thank you. for what a show. Argentina has gone to town over the death of an actress called Eva Perón. We've all gone crazy, mourning all day and mourning all night, falling over ourselves to get more of the misery right. Oh, what an exit, that's how to go. When they're ringing your curtain down, demand to be buried like Eva Perón. It's quite a sunset, and good for the country in a roundabout way. We've made the front page of all the world's papers today. But who is this Santa Evita? Why all this howling, hysterical sorrow? What kind of goddess has lived among us? How will we ever get by without her? She had her moments, she had some style. The best show in town was the crowd outside the Casa Rosada, Eva Perón! But that's all gone now. As soon as the smoke from the funeral clears, we're all gonna see and how she did nothing for years. Supposed to have been immortal. That's all they wanted, not much to ask for. But in the end, you could not deliver. See, you fool, what a guy is wrong. Enjoy your friends because you haven't got long. Your queen is dead, your king is through. She's not coming back to you. Show business kept us all alive since 17 October 1945. But the star is gone. That's a pretty bad state for a state to be in. Instead of government, we had a state. Instead of ideas, of for real amount of weight. Instead of hope, we were giving up proud. She didn't say much, but she said it loud. But who am I, dares to keep his head up high while millions weep? Why the exception to the rule? Opportunist, traitor, fool, or just a man who grew and saw from 17 to 24 his country bled. Crucified, she's not the only one who died. Sing, you fool, but you got it wrong. Enjoy your friends because you haven't got long. Your queen is dead, your king is through. She's not coming back to you.
Yeah. All she had, she wasn't in your contract.
no point in resisting. She's made up her mind, you've no choice. Why don't you be the man who discovered her? You'll never be remembered for your voice.
The city can be paradise for those who have the cash, the class and the connections, what you need to make a splash. The likes of you get swept up in the morning with the trash. If you were rich or middle class,
much trouble.
Beware of the city. It's hungry and cold. Can't be controlled. It is mad. Those who are fools are swallowed up whole. And those who are not become what they should not become. Changed. In short, they go bad.
For me, I'm born so clean and so ignored.
Finally say, you have your way, come to town. But you'll look to me with a foreigner's eyes, the younger girl city, a magical city, a fantasy long since put down.
Done to me was that a young girl's fantasy. I played the city game, all right, didn't I? I already know what coat, color, dirty city feels and looks. I tasted it last night, didn't I?
It's hungry and cold, can't be controlled, will run wild. This in a man is a danger enough, but you are a woman, not even a woman, not very much more than a child, and whatever you say, I'll not steal you away.
Thank you.
life. The descamisados, the sharpest one, the butchers, the doctors, the shuffling workers in the stockyard, in the factory, and on the treadmill. Do these people have views, ambitions, opinions? They will soon. Don't you love the smack of firm governance? We all appreciate the invaluable support, order, and purpose provided from our military to our Constitution, but it will soon be time for the military to become our Constitution. Say some, notably, the military. The gathering of people around those, the rolls, the dailies, the hammers of parrots, the procession of nannies from England and France, who on earth or in Argentina would want to pull the rug out from underneath the polished feet of the cream of Buenos Aires society?
Thank you.
send her a spot on the sound radio. We'll think of you every time she's on the air, and we'd love you to stay, but you'd be in the way. So do up your trousers and go. Monopolize with fingers in dozens of different pies.
on this night.
Arena Park Stadium, Buenos Aires, January 22nd, 1944.
On this night.
A concert in aid of the victims of an earthquake that devastated the town of San Juan, Argentina.
On this night of a thousand stars, let me take you to heaven's door, where the music of love's guitar plays forevermore.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Augustin Legaldi. Any minute now, the man of the hour.
Ava Duarte.
Your act hasn't changed much.
Neither has yours.
Tonight I'm proud to be the people's spokesman. You've given help to those who've lost their homes, but more than that, conclusively shown that the people should run their affairs on their own. Make sure your leaders understand the people.
Shy goodbye, creeping home before it gets too
There is no one, no one at all. Never has been, and never will be a lover, male or female, who has in denial that they rely on the tricks they can try on their partner. They're hoping their lover will help them or keep them, support them, promote them, don't blame them. You're the same.
Thank you. I detect the resistance to
precisely
our heroine style.
Thank you.
knives are out. Would-be presidents are all around. I don't say they mean harm, but they each give an arm to see us 6 feet underground.
It doesn't matter what those morons say. Our nation's leaders are a feeble crew. There's only 20 of them anyway. And what is 20 next to millions too? I'm looking to you. All you have to do is sit and wait, just keeping out of everybody's way. You'll be handed power on a plate when the ones who matter have their say, and with chaos in store, you can reluctantly agree to be called.
There again, we could be foolish not to quit while we're ahead. For distance lends enchantment, and that is why all exiles are distinguished. More important, they're not dead. I could find job satisfaction in Paraguay.
This is crazy defeatist talk. Why commit political suicide? There's no risk, there's no call for any action at all when you have unions on your side.
Your
stay. Head on, have a sign from the army, and this we abide.
not to quit while I'm ahead. I can see me many miles away, in fact here, sipping cocktails on a terrace, taking breakfast in bed, sleeping easy, doing crosswords, it's attractive.
Don't think I don't think like you, I often get those nightmares today.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Argentina.
Spain has fallen to the charms of Evita. She can do what she likes, doesn't matter much. She's a real Madonna with a golden touch. She filled up for the ring 45,000 seater. But if you're prettier than General Franco, that's not hard.
Same thing in Italy, please.
Now I don't like to spoil a wonderful story, but the news from Rome isn't quite so good. She hasn't gone down like we thought she would. Italy's unconvinced by Argentine glory. They equate head on with Mussolini. Can't think why.
I'm still caught in that rope, yet I gave up the sea long ago.
Things aren't all that bad, she met with a pope. She got a papal declaration and a kindly word.
So even if the crowd gave her lady the bird,
the Argentine Italy accent does have some hope. She still made a fabulous impact on the
like the sun through the post-war haze, a beautiful reminder of the carefree days. She nearly captured the French, she sure had a chance, but she suddenly seemed to lose interest. She looked tired.
Tired, Eva, tired!
Face the facts, the rainbow started to fade. I don't think we'll make it to England now.
It wasn't on the schedule anyhow.
You'd better get out the flags and fix the parade. Some kind of coming home and triumph is required.
Let's hear it for the rainbow touring. Been an incredible success. We weren't quite sure, we had a few doubts.
The answer is
yes,
and no,
and yes,
and no,
and yes, and no.
Let's hear it for the rainbow tour. It's been an incredible success.
Who the hell does the King of England think he is? He is some tin pot castle of his. What kind of invitation is that? Argentina's first lady deserves Buckingham Palace. If England can do without me, then Argentina can do without England. should have asked her to be. The actress hasn't learned the lines you like to hear. She won't join your clubs. She won't dance in your halls. She won't help the hungry once a month at your tombolas. She'll simply take control as you disappear.
Thank you. teapot that no one seen them. Oh, what bliss to sign your check at 301 to step on. Never been that count in the name of Babe Pedder!
Yeah!
pleasures and thereby restore self-esteem. How could you be so short-sighted to look never further than this week or next week to have no impossible dream?
Allow me before you slink off to the sideline to march your adieu with three cheers. But first tell me who'd be delighted to know that I tackled the world's greatest problems from war to pollution, no solution. Even if I live the 100 years,
there is evil ever around. Fundamental system of government quite incidental.
So go if you're able to somewhere and stand on the stage. Get quit of your hate in some tottering state. But not here, dear, that clear, dear.
It's all very well to a certain extent for the lady at the side of the president
to show an interest in affairs. But let's not be blind to the critical events. She's eclipsing the strength of a daughter, and she will return soon to the little stairs. She will never win her heart. She's a woman for a start. She owes no elected post. She's an ornament at most.
But on the other hand, she's all they have. She's a diamond in their dark gray lives, and that's the hardest kind of stone. It usually survives. And if you think about it, can you recall the last time they loved anyone at all? She's not some bauble you can brush aside. She's been outdoing what we've just talked about. Example, gave us back our businesses, got the English out. And if you think about it, well, why not do one or two of the things we promised to? But on the other hand, she's slowing down. She's lost a little of that magic drive, but I would not advise those critics present to deny. Any satisfaction from her being starved, she's the one who's kept us where we are.
She's the one who's kept you where you are.
What's new, Buenos Aires? Your nation, which had the second largest gold reserve in the world, is now bankrupt. A country which grew up and grew rich on beef is now rationing it. La Prensa, one of the few newspapers who dared to oppose Peronism, has now been silenced. I'll tell you what's new, Argentina.
Dice are rolling, the knives are out. I see every bad sign in the book, and as far as they can, overweight to a man, they have that lean and hungry look.
But we still have the magic we've always loved. The desk comisados to worship me. We arrive thanks to them and no one else. But thanks to your generals, a clutch of stuffed cuckoos.
It's not a question of a big parade. Proving we're big with the mobs on the street.
You're wrong! The people, my people!
The people belong to no one. They are because can be manipulated. They don't matter. However much they love you now, it matters more that as far as my stuffed cuckoos are concerned, you don't politically exist.
So I don't exist, so I'll count for nothing. Try saying that on the street when all over the world I am Argentina.
recognized by their own mothers.
But they'll admit I exist when I become vice president.
That won't work. We've been through all of this before. They'd bite you tooth and nail. You'd never overcome them with 100 rallies. And even if you did,
yes,
your little body is slowly breaking down. You're losing speed, you're losing strength, not style. That goes on flourishing forever. But your eyes, your smile, do not have the sparkle of their fantastic past. If you climb one more mountain, it could be your last.
I'm not that ill. Bad moments come, but they go. Some days are fine, some a little bit harder. But that doesn't mean I should change my routine. Have you ever seen me defeated? Don't you forget what I've been through, and yet I'm still standing. And if I am ill, that could even be to your advantage.
Advantage? I am trying to point out that you are dying. This talk of death is chilling, but of course, you're not going to die.
Then I must now be vice president, and I shall have my people come to choose to sad for her country,
leave you, though it may get harder for you to see me. I'm Argentina, and always will be. I said too much. There's nothing more I can think of to say to you. But all you have to do is look at me to know that every word is true.
And here.
Vita. Only the pedestal was completed. And her body disappeared for 17 years.
Lighting and sound. If you guys could please come down real quick. wronged you so much. Mrs. Kane and Mrs. Skotek. Mrs. Kane helps us with all of our makeup and hair backstage. She did all the wig changes for Megan and Alicia. And Mrs. Skotek helps us with all of our props and everything. My giant suitcase.
The next thanks I'd like to give goes out to two people very close to me, Mrs. Lyons and my... Yeah! And my mother, Mrs. Goodman. They've been doing costumes for the past 4 years through all these shows, and my mother has supported me in this program for the better part of 7 years now, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart for everything you've done.
Alright, the next person we would like to thank is super, super important for the making of our sets. And it's super amazing because he doesn't really have a kid in the program anymore, and we're just like, you know, he's still here, and it's awesome. That person I'd like to thank is Mr. Uncle Russ. She was a new addition this year. She really helped out a lot in Legally Blonde with the pre-show, and with this show, she's been an amazing help. She's been the director's assistant and everything. Thank you, Mason. I mean, she's been a really important person in this team, and that person, Miss Kara Greco.
Director happens to be our pit director also, and the phenomenal music is directed by our very own Mrs. Thomas.
Mrs. Umstead. She is the head stage manager and I'm the student stage manager. Thank you so much for dragging me into this mess of chaos and late nights. It has been so much fun.
Okay, so the next person we want to thank is, both of them are very near and dear to my heart. Is Mr. Arters. He spends so many Saturdays here, all Saturdays here, now all year long, now that we do three shows, come see Coastline. And, but there are no sets, so sorry, Dad. Maybe you get some Saturdays off.
Okay, anyway, he does so much work, and obviously I love him for other reasons other than his amazing sets. But I think that everyone else here can say that they love him because of these sets, and because of just the personality that he brings to the stage when he's, you know, backstage and everything. We love you, Dad. This next person, because I think I have been waiting like 12 years or so to actually do it myself. I have watched everyone thank her, and to them it means so much, but to me it means so much more, because everything that I know I have learned from this woman, and I know that everyone loves her, but I love her so much more. So sorry, you can't have her. But Mrs. Arters, everything you do for us, I can't even thank you enough. And I know that I'm a better person. We all are better people because you have been in our lives. So thank you.
This particular class is near and dear to my heart. I've known McKenna and Megan since on stage, since they were Molly and Annie. Ben was Guy Masterson in a very cute middle school, Guys and Dolls, with Evan, who was all glasses and teeth at the time, and still is. No, he grew into his teeth. Megan and Mike were in the middle school performances with Jillian and so many others. It's really hard when your kid is part of this. And they were clowns. It was lovely. I have video too. So, and thank you to Mrs. Rothman, who helps train all of these kids, and to Mrs. Thomas and Mr. Selfridge and all the music people that helped these kids become so talented. But most of all, thanks to all of you. When you read the news and see the news lately, it can be upsetting. I'm very proud to live in the community that we live in. We are all very lucky because Garnet Valley is one of the greatest places I've ever lived, and it has some of the greatest kids that we're ever going to send out into this world. So thank you all very much. Have a good night. And underclassmen parents, you better step up, because there's some awesome senior parents that are graduating too. Thank you.